return to the turbine. So in this turbine we will conduct the experiment. So first thrust is in input turbine. So before conducting experiment on this turbine, so let us study different parts of the turbine, how the turbine works. So in case of input turbine, there is a reservoir. From the reservoir, water flows to a penstock line. This one is a penstock line or pipeline. So which water from the reservoir flows to the pipeline, and to the pipeline, the water flows to the turbine runner through a nozzle. At the end of the pipeline, there is a nozzle fitted. So water with high speed flows to the turbine through the nozzle. So that means in the reservoir, water is at high head. So the hydraulic energy converted to mechanical energy while the water flows to the nozzle to the runner. So here in place of reservoir, there is a centrifugal pump. We are creating the head, high head. So with limited water, we are running the turbine. In place of, for experimental purpose, in place of reservoir, we have a centrifugal pump. So this is the penstock line or the pipeline. Here is the nozzle. So nozzle, inside the nozzle there is a sphere with the hand wheel. We are making to and fro, moving to and fro the sphere inside the nozzle. So this one is the runner of the input turbine. So number of buckets are fitted on the periphery of the runner. So this is the runner of the moving part of the turbine, and this one is the casing, so which covers the runner. So the function of the casing is to avoid accident to the operator and flashing of water. So water jeta chitiki thanda ada sare no chitiki adite roy. So water after doing work inside the turbine, so it gets discharged to the tailless and flow to the canal. So this is the working of the turbine, input turbine. So these are different parts of the input turbine. Then we start. So when we are starting the centrifugal pump, in place of the reservoir, there is a centrifugal pump. We start the centrifugal pump. So the centrifugal pump will discharge water with the high pressure. So the high pressure water will flow through the nozzle. So we can control the water flow through the by operating the hand wheel. That means the sphere is inside the nozzle. So the sphere will move to and fro inside the nozzle. So which will control the flow. Then when the turbine is running, so we will apply some load here. So this is the brake drum which is inbuilt with the shaft of the turbine. So we will apply external load here. These are the external loads, 500 gram. So when we will place the wire, so there is a swing balance reading. So swing balance reading is, so maximum reading is 2.5 kg. So the we will apply half kg or 500 gram weight at external load. We will measure the swing balance reading. So then according to the different formula in the manual, we will calculate HP, power developed by the turbine. So let us start the turbine.